there? What are you doing?
Huh?
Are you studying right before the date that you planned?
Actually, I'm doing a thesis, so it's actually George Berkeley's criticism on inclusive
culture. What? Okay, my gosh, man.
Sorry about that. Okay.
It's okay, I'm sorry I snapped at you, but let's be frank, I don't really think that this dating thing will work out.
But why? We barely got to know each other and the date hasn't even started.
I think you're really different from me and most of all, you like math.
But math is something that is very important in our life.
Yeah, sure, I like quick math.
Quick math?
Yeah, quick math. 2 plus 2 equals 4 minus 1. You know what, I don't really think we'll work out.
But if outside of mathematics, you still need to know some translation and transformation.
What do you mean by that?
What I mean is that, even you think that we are not compatible, but I think that we still have something inside each other. So, trust me, I think we'll work out, we'll find something with. You know what? Give me 10 days.
10 days?
Yes. Give me 10 days to change your mind.
Okay. The flowers are really pretty, right?
Yeah, they sure are. In fact, if I may, you would say they are mathematically perfect.
Well, I can never get you to stop talking about math, huh?
But it's true, you know, the Fibonacci spiral actually exists everywhere in nature, from pineapples to pine cones.
Wait, what? The Fibo what?
The Fibonacci spiral. Come. So, the Fibonacci spiral is actually an approximation of the golden spiral, you know, created by drawing circular arcs connecting the opposite corners of squares using the sizes of 1 cm square, 1 cm square, and then so the next number is actually a summation of the two numbers before it, and it results in the most efficient way to pack things together in the most aesthetically attractive pattern.
Wow, that's actually kind of cool.
Yeah, that's why my favorite flower is actually the sunflower, because they are the one of the biggest and prettiest demonstrations of the hidden mathematical rules that shapes actually the patterns of life.
Wow, you know what? That's actually my favorite flower too.
Oh really? That's cool.
Hey, what you doing, Mr.
Hugo? Hey, hello. I'm just working on my paper. Not sure if you remember, but it was actually the thesis that I did on our first date.
What was it about again?
It's something really complicated. It's about the division of zero.
The division of zero?
Yeah. So basically, there is an elegant concept of infinity. For example, if you take anything divided by zero, right, let's say 1, you won't be able to define it. Okay? However, if you look at it from a perspective of 1 divided by anything, so let's say 1 divided by 0.5, that gives you 2, 1 divided by 0.2 is 5. So as x gets closer to 0, you will eventually hit an arbitrary large number, or infinity.
So does that mean that anything divided by 0 equals to infinity?
You can say so.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Shall I get going?
Okay. Oh, I got you a flower for Valentine's.
What happened though? Valentine's Day isn't until next week.
Well, our 10 days is coming to an end after today.
Yeah, time actually went by really quickly.
Yeah, I guess. This is the end.
Hey, wait, let me do it.
What's that?
It's 1 over 0.
1 over 0?
Yeah, 1 over 0. And that's infinity, right?
Life is nothing but a sequence of random events, but I somehow found her. I made her this flower for Valentine's, secretly made out of Mobius strips. Hopefully, our love will be just like the Mobius strip, always being able to find our way back to each other. With her, I think I have finally found my infinity.